On this episode of Beyond the Marquee, we're here at the 30th anniversary Knight Rider reunion. You ready, Kit?
Just remember, this is business, not pleasure.
Steve Czarnecki here for Beyond the Marquee, and today I'm here at the Beverly Garland Hotel in Universal City, California. Now, this is a fan event 3 decades in the making. If you're a fan of Knight Rider, buckle up, because we're here today at the Knight Rider 30th Anniversary Reunion. You know, 30 years ago, they said one man can make a difference. 30 years later, one man is making a difference. Nick Nugent, who is the organizer behind this Knight Rider 30th reunion. Nick, how are you?
I'm doing fantastic. How about you?
All right, so yeah, I'm doing great, and I'm so excited to be here. This is such a cool event for if you're a Knight Rider fan. I mean, everything, you've got cast, you've got the cars, you've got props. How did this all come about?
This basically came about to organize a fan experience like no other, like our tagline says. We wanted to bring the fans closer to the cast and crew, the props, like you said, true history, to get as close to the television show as humanly possible 30 years later.
Isn't this a beautiful car? I feel right back at home.
All right, an honor to be here with April Curtis, otherwise known as actress Rebecca Holden from Knight Rider.
Thank you so much. It's a great day to be here at Universal Studios celebrating this iconic show that is so beloved to all of us.
I mean, and it's such an action-packed show and drama. I mean, what are the memories that stand out for you?
Well, it was a wonderful show to be a part of. I actually had the privilege of playing April because she was a wonderful role model for young women. And we had a ball doing the show. Of course, it was a hit show, but you would never imagine that it would have the impact around the world that it's had and that it would continue to endure the way it has all these years later and bring people together at events just like this from around the world. I think we have people here today from Germany and South Africa and Japan. Yep. It's just quite amazing, and it's quite humbling to think that a show that you were a part of is still making a difference in people's lives and that it has been embraced by audiences the way that it has. So it's something very, very special. I think all of us, you know, who had the great privilege of being a part of this show feel very blessed.
All right, we're here with Peter Parros. You might know him as RC3 from Knight Rider. Thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure. Great to be here.
So 30 years has gone by. Does it seem like it's been that long since you were in the night truck working on kids?
No, it doesn't seem like it until you really think about it. It seems like it was maybe 10 years ago, but then when you realize all that's happened since then, it's like, wow, yeah, it's 30 years. For me, it was the first series I had done, my first series regular role. So it was very exciting. I loved action, fighting ninjas with a snow shovel. I always talk about that was just like nowhere else could you fight with a snow shovel and win.
Just the action and the drama that was surrounded each week behind it. What are some of your memories?
I remember not being allowed to drive. Only David was allowed to drive Kit. It's amazing to look at all the cars here now and see it still looks like a futuristic car. So the car was like timeless.
So I'm here with Jeff Osterhage. You may remember him from K.I.T.T vs. Car Season 3. This is an amazing story. People may not know this about you. You were actually in line for being the role of Michael Knight. Is this right?
Exactly. Listen, it was down to 4 people. Guy, I can't think of his name, but Don Johnson, Hasselhoff, and me. So for a few days it was going on. We were waiting on pins and needles to see who got the role, and turns out 2 weeks later they said that Hasselhoff got it because Brandon Tartikoff was on the airplane with Hasselhoff and just said hi to him and got to know him and thought he was a nice guy and thought, well, let's give him a chance. You talk about fate and Hollywood and all that, I would have been Michael Knight, and of course I can't sing and I wouldn't have gone to Germany and cut records.
We're here with Richard Anderson. Surprise visit here. Thanks for coming out to the Knight Rider 30th reunion. What's it like to be out here?
Incredible. I just got here. But the reason I did it, I've been doing a lot of series, and I've been in a lot of, you know, first parts and everything. But I read the script and they sent it to me, and all it was just one scene in the beginning. But the scene was, I'm a doctor who's saving the leading man's life. I'm saving his life, yeah. You understand? So I said, geez, I got to do it for this guy, not knowing who he is or what he is. And I went and shot it, and we shot it, you know, maybe about 3 hours, and all the actors and everybody were around watching me, you know. So the interesting part of this whole thing, I did it in one take.
Hey, if there's anybody to talk to about Knight Rider, it's this guy, Joe Huth. He's a Knight Rider historian. So tell us, how does one become a Knight Rider historian? Just watching a lot of episodes?
No, you're going to have to go to college and major in it.
How many interviews have you done for your book?
Did about 30 for the first book. And then this new book, which was just released, we upped the ante. We did 65 brand new interviews. Everyone from producers on the show all the way down to single episode guest stars. The goal was to get an interview for every single episode produced.
Is the Hoff in there?
Oh, the Hoff. No.
Is he in the first book?
No.
Come on, David.
He has eluded
Joe Huth
us.
Needs the interview.
He has eluded us for over 10 years.
So 30 years of a lone crusader in his talking car. Where do people get this book?
Amazon.com. And, you know, they're available in both paperback and hardback. And I'm actually working on a Kindle version. It'll be the first Knight Rider Kindle version. Since, you know, that's the way all these books are going, I figured it's only natural. So we'll see how that
goes.
Can
I suggest something?
Absolutely.
Instead of Kindle, could you do a K.I.T.T version?
Oh, there's the hook. Absolutely.
So what brought you out here to the Knight Rider 30th reunion today?
I've always been a lifelong fan of Knight Rider. I've revered the show ever since I was young. This is one of the few TV shows that are truly, truly global. So growing up in the late 1980s, Knight Rider gave me escapism, it gave me a fantasy world, and it was always my dream to see K.I.T.T in person and to also meet and greet the cast and stars.
And so, and today is that day, right?
Today is that day, dream come true. Today ranks up there with my other minor accomplishments in life.
Well, that's going to do it here for this episode of Beyond the Marquee. Special thanks to the Knights of the West Coast, Nick Nugent, to put this all on. We've had a great time here today. We met some of the cast from Knight Rider. We've seen some of the props and even got to sit inside one of the K.I.T.T cars. That's like a dream come true. For Beyond the Marquee, I'm Steve Czarnecki. Have a great day. Or should I say, have a great night. Now, here's the biggest question I'm sure everybody has. Do you talk to K.I.T.T while you're driving? I mean, do you kind of put yourself into that mode where you just, you become Michael Knight? I mean, you've got the car. I mean, how do you not role play?
Yeah, once in a while. Well, I try not to do that. You know, it's just for fun, once in a while, yeah.
You crank up the theme, right?
Yeah, definitely. Oh, yeah.
Check out Beyond the Marquee online. Like us on Facebook, subscribe to our YouTube channel, or follow our tweets on Twitter. Thanks for watching.
Good night.